Hey everyone. I got into the office like way early today because I had to drive Julie to an exam. And I decided to play a little Dark Souls, but I can't get the fucking controller to work. Press start. I'm pressing start. I don't know what to do. I've tried plugging it into other USB ports. I mean, it's lit up, but it's lit up on two. And I also checked it in Windows control panel and like calibrated the controller, and it's fine. All the lights light up when I press the buttons. Unplug every other controller. Oh, God. Hold on. Okay. Interesting. This is the other one. There's another one plugged in. Properties, settings. How do I disable you? Where's the Xbox One controller? You look like an Xbox One controller. No. Aha! Found it! Son of the. Haha! You did a thing, chat. Oh, I'll kill you. Nope. I said it was gonna be ninja sword and sorcery, so here we are. And really, we're just gonna do like the first couple of hours again. What's a good color for a sorcerer? Oh, we're definitely going sorcerer because I want to do. Some stuff. Sure, we'll be silver-haired. Turn off 60 FPS. Oh, that was such a good noise. No, we want 30 FPS so our rolls work. It's good to be home. How are you guys? I've got like a couple of hours before anyone else shows up, so I thought I'd stream. Here we are. So, plan is we, graveyard to New Londo. We do New Londo and pick up like parrying sword. Yeah, I'll be at Pax Valdor. Or parrying dagger. Then we go to. Then we start the game, really. is still coffee. Excuse me. That is the first time that guy's hit me in like a year. Wow, what a jerk. It might be a karate sword. I don't know. I'm not from the Great East, or whatever it's called in this game. I don't know the pronunciation of things. It's spelled ninja sword, but Adam pronounces it karate sword, so I mean... I'm tired this morning, the Flan Man. I like our little beret. Or is it a tam? Just skip through Oscar's dying monologue. Maybe it's in the game files. No. Where it's actually revealed to be named Karate Sword. I have not tried No Man's Sky, because I cannot afford No Man's Sky. I should buy No Man's Sky for myself. Where'd you come from? Anyways, we'll go pick up the karate sword from House of Knives. Oh, right. We should probably equip our catalyst. I've also been doing like a, oh, wait, put it in the wrong hand. Lol, I'm bad. I've been doing an SL1 run at home, which is kind of neat. I thought the spiritual ancestor of No Man's Sky was, Escape Velocity. And, right into the medulla. Good album. I prefer Vespertine. Alright, now we just... Dude, if you keep doing that, you're gonna break through the floor. Nobody wants that. Alright, quick, get clear before his bowels release. Ugh, I'm so bored of the spore comparison to No Man's Skies. Or No Man's Sky. It's like, ah, yeah, come back when you have something to say. An SL1 run of Dark Souls is one where you start with Pyromancer, because Pyromancer starts off at soul level 1. And you see in top left where it says level... Sorcerer starts at level 3. Pyromancer starts at soul level 1. And so what you do, it's the only class that starts at level 1. And you just... You're only allowed to level up your equipment. You have a very reduced selection of equipment because your stats are so low you can only equip, like, certain weapons. I'm gonna pop all my I'm gonna pop these four humanity right here just so I can, like, get decent drop rates on things. Deprive starts at soul level 11, I think. The reason Pyromancer starts at soul level 1 is because I think, just because Pyromancer Flame is such a good piece of equipment. Like, I think it basically balances out your equipment and your soul level. So, like, Sorcerer starts off reasonably low at soul level 3 because we have a catalyst and, a bunch of spells. I guess the devs feel that Pyromancer starting Flame and their Fireball spell counts for several levels. Yeah, you can upgrade the Pyromancer. You can upgrade whatever you can equip, right? If you can get it, you can use it. Or if you can use it, you can upgrade it. See, this is where I'm just gonna punt everything in the graveyard because I'm terrible at this game. Oh yeah, yeah, the Pyromancer set is really, really good as well. Like, it's got... it's very lightweight, and it has really good stats. Hold on. There we go. Hold on. I'm just gonna knock you two together. And see if I can make these two kiss. Go for the simultaneous double kill. Yes, got there. Okay. The Flan Man, I kind of got used to profs not responding super quickly, so I just started going to office hours. I mean, I realize it's rarely an option for everyone. I live close to the university, so I could just, like, drop in. Goodbye! Yeah, this is like Petrus's secret stash. He's got, like, invasion items and a bleed weapon. Yeah, good catch, Tregolin. Uh-oh. Ah, there we go. Off you go! Bye! I've actually never played a cleric. From what I get, like, you, I guess you want to go heavy armor because the cleric spells seem to, like, encourage you to get, like, right up into melee. The simultaneous double kill. Oh, that sounds really stressful, the Flan Man. I'm very sorry to hear that. My favorite interaction with my honor supervisor was her, was me asking how I did a certain thing in Fiesta, and her telling me, oh, it's easy, I'll just email you the manual again. This is where we fall apart. Yeah, bad at this game. So used to having Wolfring. So used to having... pause. There we go. Now I'll wait for you to get out. JK. You're still alive? Dear God, man. Yeah. Potato Gangsta, Agatha Fisty is Graham's thing. Uh-oh. Stay down. The Ninja Eye, we will be going with the ninja sword that is sold at the House of Knives in Undeadburg. I mean, I love my honor supervisor so much, she's amazing. But it was just like, the archetypal interaction. These guys, I swear. Look at them, look at them. There we go. fine, I'll just kill your buddy. There. How's that parrying working for you? Not so good? I am going to try to work on a book for Aiton. Chaos Blade?
Ugh.
It requires strength 14. TBH, Uchigatana already requiring, like, strength 14 and Agi 14 is kind of a tall order. I mean, like, I get that having dex is not totally useless for a sorcerer because it improves your casting time, like, slightly at dex 40. I've seen videos where I think you get, like, what, like, a third of a second improvement in casting time at dex 40? Oh, I just did an honors degree. So, for an honors degree in Canada, you do an honors thesis. Which is, like, a very, very, very short, you know, independent research project. Which is supposed to be, like, training for grad school. So I had a supervisor for that. She is someone I would like to do a graduate degree with, because she was very good to me. Oh, shit. You know what? I'm tired of your shit, son. Just get arrowed. Arrowed you right in your chest. Yeah, the Yaito's really good. It's got a cool, like, I love the reach on its strong attack. It's just the 20 dex requirement is really high. I'd rather put it into endurance. Yeah, your spell uses come back at a campfire. Or at a bonfire. Wait, did I get the other soul item? The one behind Petrus? Does anyone remember? Looks like it. Alright, we're gonna go down and see Rickard and buy his spells. Or some of his spells. We could probably go get Pinwheel. I've never done, like, a speed run to Pinwheel, though. Oh yeah, again, we're like 400 short. The soul, actually, let's talk to Crestfallen Knight.
Wow.
Hey, buddy. Everything's gonna be okay, don't you worry. You're gonna be fine. We're gonna get through this together, okay? Don't do anything rash. I get it. I get it. I see you, man. You gotta laugh at it, right? Because that's how you pull through. I see you. We're good. We're solid. We're gonna make this, gonna make it through this one together, buddy. I really should try to scrape together the money to buy No Man's Sky, because everyone says it's sweet. This is going to take me to... Yes! Yes, yes it is. Hey, Rickard. I like Rickard's strategy for getting through life. Step one, don't give a shit. Step two, go fuck yourself. Fat stacks of podcaster money. No. Ah, that's Rickard who has the rapier. This is Rickard. Presumably they're a different guy. Oh man, mind blown. What if Rickard is Rickard? Okay, what we're going to do is attune the spells, and then go back, and then just walk through New Londo, wishing a motherfucker would. Maybe we'll drop in on Ingward. Ingward seems lonely. We'll go see him. Make sure he's doing alright. Hello, MDK Marshall. Basically what I'm doing here is I want to go through and get the, you know what? I'm gonna leave that there. This guy seems in mourning. I'm not gonna rob from his buddy. Or I'm not going to rob his buddy. Basically what we can do in New Londo is get, like, a ludicrous number of souls and soul items at this stage in the game. Maybe we'll also get like a jagged ghost blade, which is useful for a little while. And we also get parrying blade, which I like since I'm getting like dex 40 anyway, so I can use Uchigatana. We'll be able to use, even though you don't actually need the dex 14 to parry with parrying blade. You can just parry with it as long as you don't try to hit anybody with it. You can still use it, same with like buckler and target shield. They all still work. And, oh yeah, we're also getting the thingy do. What? Ha, idiots. Whoops. Oh, okay, looks like we both whiffed that attack. It's okay. Do-over? Do-over. I know sketchy details. I know. Yeah, the Firekeeper Soul. Firekeeper Soul, very good at this point in the game. Because once we get to Undead Parish, we'll have a plus two flask. We get ye flask. It's all in the hips. I've never actually bothered upgrading parrying dagger. I guess nobody expects you to hit with it, right? Do not get stuck in a wall. I can't get your items if you get stuck in a wall. No item anyway.
Idiot.
Where do you think you're running to, son? No Jagged Ghostblade yet. Well, that's kind of a letdown. Alright, well, let's kill this dude. Yeah, toodles. Oh, promising. Ying! 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 Come to Papa. Where are you now? Come to Papa. Okay, everything's going well. Everything's going well. We're just gonna drive this guy into the ground like a tent peg. And then we'll be smooth. Everything will be hip. Everything will be happening. Hi, buddy. I can still see you, you know. Drop something. Oh, transient curse ran out. That's why we keep the transient curse in our active slot when we're in New Londo. You think so, huh? Nice floor, idiot. You will be a Jagged Ghostblade.
Damn it.
Oh, how surprising. There was a ghost waiting in ambush for us. I've probably played too much of this game. Good old parrying dagger. Nothing beats parrying dagger. Once again, our objective here is to try to get the green Titanite shard. You know what? I'm bored of you. Goodbye. Oh really? You can just... I didn't know quitting the game actually turned the transient curse off, so if it's about to run out, you can just refresh it. That's actually super useful. Come on, come down here. If you pop an item, I want to be able to collect it. No, you son of a bitch! Come back here and fight me! 1v1. No jagged ghost blade. The hell's going on? Let's go and kill the guys down here. Just so... It's rare, but I've actually had them, like, come up behind me while I'm trying to clear the cathedral. Oh, this is so dicey. This is so dicey. Ah, shit. Seven shits. Camera, please. Camera, please. Ding-ing. Mace, you suck. You suck, Mace. All right. Crisis averted. Everything's fine. So what we're going to do is try to pull the guys from inside the cathedral out, and they should just start wandering up out of here. Oh, fuck me. No, 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 no. Everything's fine. Nothing is fucked. Nothing is fucked. Just have to remember they're a bunch of amateurs. No jacket ghostblade. I've got to kill the three ghosts down here. Come on. Come on. It's okay. Come out and play. Boo. Oh, totally. What we're doing is we're going straight for Four Kings after this. We're going hell for leather for Four Kings. And then we'll get Beatrice's set. Because Beatrice is bae. Then we'll have our proper robe and wizard hat. Robe in wizard hat. The important thing in New Londo is to remember that you can actually just die at any time. For really not well-explained reasons. Sometimes a ghost is just like, I'm totally gonna kill you now, okay? Like in this situation where we're going to die. Transient cursed. Curse. I will kill you. I will kill you. I will kill you. Why? Why? There. Yes! This is the part of the game where we get greedy and die here. We don't really have the hit points to just get greedy on this shit. He said, getting greedy on this shit. Hey, don't you worry. We now have ape shit attack. So there's like, I think that's another humanity, and then, or is that the sacrifice ring? There's another humanity, I think. Yeah, if you guys aren't familiar with the knifey stabby. And then, don't get too close to the edge there. I have a Tumblr that I never update. It was called Classical Bay. I don't think there's, because we can't, can we get composite bow now? Is this where we get curse bite ring? Right, which is actually reasonably handy. Well, no, it's not. I've only ever used curse bite ring when fighting what, Sen? No, Seath. Seath. Dude, are you kidding? This attack animation is like the most cathartic thing in the game when you're just like, die, 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 die. Because you've died so many times and you're just crying and there's snot and like everything coming down your face. And you just need to like, you know, stab something. But I think 6,000 souls is probably just right. We're playing Journey next week, the Flan Man. Let's just get the hell out of here. Board a new Londo. Bored of it. Done. Zaphon, it probably the best thing to start off with in Dark Souls is Warrior, I think. Just because it teaches you good fundamentals. Like you have a heater shield at the beginning, which is really, really an excellent shield, for its weight. You have Longsword, which has a very, very good move set. Your leather armor is fine. You've got a good distribution of stats, so you can do things like, you can play like sword and board, right? So you can like protect yourself and strike, or you can do parries. It's a very flexible starting class that's resilient enough that you have the kind of the ability to learn without dying instantly. Yeah, like, heater shield is almost unreasonably good. You want to see something satisfying? Yeah, just get right- Dude, you're stuck on my sword, that's gross. Get off! It's so visceral. Liluvathan, I don't accept requests on Facebook from people I don't know in real life, and I do not have any pets, unfortunately. I used to have a cat. Well, my parents had a cat. And she got old and died. It was very sad. I love that cat. But, you know, even to kings he comes. I mean, yeah, the Crest Shield's outclass Heater Shield, but, like, for starting equipment that you can carry basically almost until the end of the game, it's pee good. All right, so we just got... Oh, I didn't kill you yet. Huh. Awkward. Excuse me. Like, the thing with Heater Shield is that it's got 100% physical defense, reasonable stability, and it weighs 2 pounds. Like, its weight makes it so good. Like, that pound is such a big difference. The Plaidmaster, I haven't actually even bought Dark Souls 3 yet. So, I don't know. Milt, I know, really didn't like Dark Souls 3. I almost get the impression that the studio was kind of done with Dark Souls, right? They made Dark Souls. They made this game. It wasn't Dark Souls 1, it was Dark Souls. And then it was so popular, and there were just enough things wrong, or not properly tuned, that they kept trying to make games. I don't know. I don't know. Dark Souls 2 wasn't made by the same people, right? Like, it was made by the Studio B team. But Miyazaki was involved in Dark Souls 3, and... I don't know. I think this game... Yeah, 3 is better than 2. 2 is not good. The term Alex and I use in describing this game is thoughtful. That feel when a fucking hollow gets a plunging attack on you. Bloodborne is great, yeah. Like, from what I've seen of Dark Souls 2, it's just... things don't make as much sense as they do in this game, right? Like, I'm not saying it's realistic, but there is a thoughtfulness to the way that things are put together in this game that was absent in Dark Souls 2. Like, this place feels... well put together. Cared for. There we go. All right, time to go to House of Knives. You two bore me. The problem with fucking Jagged Ghostblade is that it doesn't have a kick animation. I've actually never taken the Master Key. I kind of enjoy a lot of the things that it allows you to bypass. Well, watch. Things are getting
confused.
You are such a fucking wiener, dude.
Here, I'm not here to chit-chat. We talk business, or we talk nothing at all. Here, I'm not... Go and fall off.
God, dude, you don't even make it difficult. You were such a wiener. Go and be with your body pillow. Weren't using your sword anyway. Nope. Why is my micro so bad? The thing I really don't like is people recommending that people doing their first playthrough of Dark Souls take the master key, because you just get, like, it adds so many choices to the game, and new players can really get lost with it, right? Like, when I first started playing this, people were like, take the master key. You have to take the master key. Why are you not taking the master key? And I was like, I don't want to do all the sequence breaks. I want to actually see this game. Unlock the power of Daikatan. Well, dude, your name is really not cool. I don't want to have to take the forest guardian, the forest friend covenant. Also, because, like, we could get washing pool, but I don't have the thingamadoo, master key, so I can't actually get there in any kind of reasonable amount of time. Yeah, Old Witch's Ring is... I'm really happy with Old Witch's Ring. It's what I have. Mainly because it allows you to unlock sadness. God, it's so sad. Like, the fact that Kirk, Knight Kirk, who invades you at several points throughout the game, is probably also just doing, is basically in your covenant and is probably just trying to get souls for Quileg's sister as well. Ugh. Medium roll is so bad. I've only gotten a washing pole once, and that was once when Alex invaded me and just gave me a washing pole. Because I think I was in, like, Depths? And I got invaded, and it was like, wait, Alex? And he just shows up, and he drops, like, a washing pole. I'm like, thanks, dude. Sweet. Yeah, Kirk is also trying to save Sunbro. The single killing stroke. The greatest compliment I ever got streaming was from somebody who was watching me play Dark Souls and said, well, this game doesn't look hard at all. Why does this game have such a reputation? This game looks easy. And I was like, I have gotten good. Well, yeah, you want to get Darkwood Green Ring, right? Here's the thing that, here's the secret about Dark Souls. Dark Souls is hard, but it is not unforgiving. Dark Souls is actually quite forgiving in certain ways. There is really no consequence to death. I mean, you can lose resources, but you can never paint yourself into a corner. Oh, thank you very much for subscribing, Toy Doll. Much appreciated. And yes, it is a surprise cam. Yeah, I mean, you also get much better with practice. Dark Souls really lets you practice, though. It's kind of impressive. You can just die over and over again trying weird, stupid shit, and the game doesn't punish you for it. I think World of Warcraft actually punishes you more for dying than Dark Souls does. So you can really kind of experiment around and practice without having to worry about things. Is everyone ready to watch me die badly? Like, just have a no-skill flameout? Yeah? Alright, let's go and do that. I've never done an MTG altar, Nero. Yeah, losing humanity is really rough. Scrub. Scurb. Oh yeah, the Black Knight Longsword is really a good weapon. You can do an entire playthrough with it. I mean, I think at the end of the game it gets outclassed by like plus 15 weapons. But if you run away, I swear to God. God, this weapon sucks. Oh, if I got the sword there, I never would have used it. Well, I don't need the pine resin, I just don't want to have to parry him like 30 times or whatever. Also, I never use pine resin otherwise, so might as well just like cut down the number of parries I need by half. But yeah, no, I suppose if I use pine resin there, I'm actually quite bad at the game, sure. Motherfucker. You know what? Eat shit, buddy. I guess Dark Souls is a bit like drafting MTG Cube. No matter what you pick, you're always wrong and stupid. Zweihänder is just like, I love Zweihänder mainly just because it's basically a railroad beam that has been sharpened to like butter knife sharpness with a handle at it. Bastard Sword has a worse move set, from what I remember. It doesn't have a thrust move at all. My favorite non-boss enemy? I really like the sorcerers. They do a little dance. Never praise me or my son ever again.
Why not help one another on this?
Yeah.
We are amidst the flow of time itself, convoluted. The very fabric wavers and relates.
Yeah, the conjurers. What are other great non-boss enemies in this game?
Jolly cooperation. Of course, we are not the only ones engaged in this, but I...
Who do I enjoy running into? Or what... Okay, what part of the game do I not find tedious? I was thinking about this the other day, where I was like, oh man, this game is so great. Except there's, you know, just like one or two tedious parts. Like, you know, Blighttown. And then Sense Fortress. Large parts of Anor Londo are pretty tedious. Catacombs, obviously. Tomb of the Giants, definitely a tedious part of the game. But I mean, after that, all you need to do is like manage Anor Londo or New Londo, which, you know, is a little tedious. And then I realized the entire fucking game is tedious. Hey TQ, what's up? Painted World is actually great. I like Painted World a lot. Except for the fucking Pinwheel Knights. Oh, I hate them so much. The Pinwheel Skeletons. Oh, they're the worst. Why? Why? Oh. Other than that, though, the game is great. Oh yeah, Lost Izalith. There's definitely like a couple of like... you are totally a Titanite shard. It's right there. Just right there. You are 800 souls that I'm going to ignore at this point in time. I mean, I totally could do this. Anyone want to see me die? Yeah, exactly. The land is peaceful and its inhabitants kind. Pinwheel skeletons. Pinwheel skeletons everywhere. All right, Milk, guide me. Nope. Uh-oh. No, we're dead. We're dead. We're dead. We're dead. Ning, 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 ning. No, we're alive. Okay. What? Son of the fuck. I'm confused, so therefore you're going to die. I've never had... Oh, it's just... Yeah. Where Dargon? Dargon gone. Yeah, I've never had that happen before. This doesn't happen to me. No, we didn't get the souls for it. Ugh, Now who wants to really watch me punt away everything? I don't even know why I'm killing this guy. He's just hanging out up here. Killing this guy, he said. Like, I'm going to actually kill this guy. He's gonna fucking clean me out. I cannot read this guy's movesets at all. Or moveset at all. I have no idea what he's ever going to do. How'd that feel when you're backstabbed to 70? Hi, I need to get behind you. Excuse me. We're gonna be here all day. We're gonna be here all day. Did I say all day? I meant he's just gonna fucking kill us. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I forgot. Do we have another ability on this character? Uh-oh. 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 Excuse me, sir. Ow. Uh-oh. Fell down the stairs. Yes, I know I'm dead. Like most enemies in Dark Souls, he wouldn't be that bad if you didn't have to fight him in a shoebox. Now I have to kill him. Because he has my souls. You know what? No, fuck this guy. Fuck you. I'm out. Oh, now he's following us, though. He's only got like 1,000 souls and a Titanite chunk, which won't be relevant until like way later in the game. No. Oh, he's totally parryable. It's just like his move. I can't read his moveset. I haven't fought him enough to be able to read his moveset, and if you miss the parry, he just kills you. Really? You can kite him to the boar? That's kind of hilarious. I hate these guys. Them and their stupid heat-seeking crossbows. Why? 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 I hate this game so much. Yeah, but I lost 5 humanity. Chat being useful as always, I see. Never saw a situation chat couldn't make worse. No, I want to at the guy who's coming right at me. Oh my god, camera. I don't even know why I fell off the ledge. There is no way I'm grinding on stream. Multiple humanity basically just ups your drop rate and improves scaling, scaling for chaos weapons. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, it boosts a couple of other things too. It's just generally useful, and it's rare. You don't get much of it in the game. So punting 5 of it is like bad feels. Well, I generally go human after Parish, or after Gargoyles, because like people on New Game Plus, PvP in the parish? So if you go human in undead parish, you'll just get murdered by somebody with, like, you know, a plus 5 lightning whatever. It's just nice to have humanity here, because these guys have, with a few humanity, these guys have a really reasonable drop rate for, Titanite shards. I mean, we could just bust all of our, like, humanity here. Fuck it, I'm doing it. Let it ride. Pablo Phoenix, Stranger Things was fine, but it felt like it copied a lot of the stylistic trappings of 1980s horror movies without understanding them or what made them good. Like, the SL1 Twinks, I actually have a hard time beating, because I can parry them, like, 4 times. Parry and riposte 4 times. But they always get me. Right? Like, I always just... All they need to do is clip you with one of their, like, massive two-handers, right? I mean, Stranger Things didn't do anything, though. Like, it was just all style with no substance. And people have been telling me, no, all, you know, like, the best things in the world are about nothing. And I'm like, I don't... What? I don't know. My experience with being human in the parish is that I can parry and riposte someone 2 or 3 times, take down, like, a quarter of their health, and then they just, like, either hit me with some kind of pyromancy or, just clip me with a giant two-hander and I die. And I never stand a chance. Like, never stood a chance. Yeah, it's, yeah, exactly, TXC too. I'm just using an Xbox 360 controller. Are you shitting me? Oh god, yeah, the fact that there's a stat that you can level up that does basically stone nothing for you is such a fuck you from the developers. Like, if you're a new player and you're dying a lot, and you see the resistance stat and you're like, oh, well, I mean, this should help my endurance, right? This should make me tougher. And then, like... I've died more in Undeadburg on stream today than I have in, like, 2 months in this game. I hate how that just happens. I've done fucked up. I have done fucked up. Why am I so bad at this? Me too, somebody nowhere. Me too. Now we have no Titanite shards. Ugh. Hi. Would you like to come outside and play? Watch me die here. What? I heard you can parry him, but you can't riposte him. Like, he doesn't have a backstab animation or something? Let's see if we killed Undead Merchant for nothing. No drop. We're missing an awful lot of these. Yeah, let's hear it for whoever just beat the gargoyles. I mean, like, my joke is that, regarding camera, if they wanted to do an easy mode of Dark Souls like they were talking about, they could just make a fucking camera that works. Playing it safe because I've got no Estus flasks left, so I'm just spamming soul arrows. Do you have titanite? You do! Hello, friend Latrec. How are you? Okay, bye. I'm sure that will have no consequences whatsoever. I wouldn't say the plot comes from the difficulty. I think there's a lot of, like, elitism about Dark Souls. I think a lot of the plot of Dark Souls is told obliquely, through items and just location. I don't think putting an easy mode in Dark Souls would decrease or would impact the plot at all. I think you would have more people playing the game who would be able to understand the plot. But yeah, I think there are definite improvements that the game could make. The atmosphere, I think, is maybe enhanced by the difficulty. I think the game experience is definitely enhanced by the game's difficulty. But it's not the only reason to play the game, right? Yeah, I mean, you don't have to use the easy mode either, right? Well, I mean, Dark Souls it's not the easiest game ever. Definitely not. I mean, it's probably like 90s hard. We did not use either of our Firekeeper souls. We went through New Londo. Got the green Titanite. But did not turn in the Firekeeper soul, because I'm stupid. Lol. Yeah, like, as a new player, I didn't understand how anything in this goddamn game worked, right? That was what gave me trouble and made me feel really helpless, and, like, the fact that the weapons guy, like, Andre explains a lot of stuff to you. Like, how far into the game is this on your first playthrough? You can take, like, it took me an hour to get here, right? And I'm pretty experienced at this game. How long is it going to take a new player to get to this point in the game before they start hearing about, like, you know, any of the things that make this game work? Yeah, like 5 hours? God. Like, the game does explain things to you, it just takes the sweet goddamn time and makes you work for explanations, which could have been in a manual. Like, the thing with 90s games is that they were hard, definitely. They also came with a manual that was about an inch thick, right? Like, they did try to explain themselves to you. Well, let's go cheese this guy out for 1,000 souls. I wonder if we're still in cover here. We are. Like, now manuals are still published, they're just sold separately and called guides for like $40. The other thing that I find really, you know, unappealing about Dark Souls is, honestly, its community, right? Oh god, I've never gotten the Titanite catchpole. Yeah, symmetrical effects are always fair. It's right there in the name, right? Like the card balance in Magic. It's right there in the name. Says it right in its name, it's balanced. So what I'm going to do now, I realized I said I wasn't going to farm on stream. I lied. The problem with manuals being a PDF is that you can't have them open on your desk in front of you while playing the game. PDFs are not as easy to navigate as a paper book, right? And you need 2 screens in order to use them while playing the game. Yeah, like iframes. The fact that iframes, like, I think both matter, Nero Wolf. Like, I'm doing an SL1 run now. I'm not very far into it. And you're totally equipment dependent in that. No, I said, controller, please. What are iframes? Iframes are invulnerability frames. Frames in which the character model is impervious to damage. Which is exactly the kind of question that any Dark Souls player should be expected to ask. They're invincibility frames, yeah. Hooray, somebody else beat the gargoyles. Right, that's a totally reasonable question. What are iframes? Sure as hell isn't explained to you anywhere in the game. Yeah. You there, come here. Fine. Oh no, you want to come and play? Hi. sick of your shit, son. Sick of your shit. Not having any of it. Yeah, we're a magical girl. We've got our magical sword. We've got our school uniform. We're basically Utena. Yeah, either the Dark Souls devs, like, assumed a very high level of literacy on the part of players in regards to this fucking game. And kind of, like, the trappings of these kinds of games. Or, like, God, I don't know. The point is, I love this game a lot. I really do. It doesn't help you out much. There are people like Crestfallen Knight who, if you click on them a lot, will tell you a lot of things about where to go and what to do. And Andre will also tell you a lot about where to go and what to do. These are things that could have gone into a manual so that new players would be able to, like, have access to them. It's okay. Oh, hey, what? Dude, harsh. Or just things like even the blocking mechanic, right? With your shield, right? When you block with your shield, it converts, what is it, its damage reduction into stam damage? Right? But that isn't explained, and when you run out of stam, you get staggered, right? I have not seen the Demon Souls manual. Or just the different kinds of damage you can take. Like, when you take poison damage, it starts filling up a meter, and when the meter is full, then you have a timer in which you're taking poison damage, right?
What are you looking at?
I get why you're hostile, man. I get it. I understand. We're gonna get through this together. It'll be okay, dude. Yeah, like how poise works. Like, there's just a bunch of mechanical stuff, right? Like, Andre can explain to you that smithing, you know, consumes titanite to make your weapon stronger, right? And that works because that is an in-game thing. Explaining stats is not something that people do well, right? It's not something that an in-game character can explain when they say, like, oh yes, you just spend souls to increase your stats. Right? They might be able to tell you something like, you know, using the souls of the undead, you can fuse the souls of the undead into yourself to gain their power, right? That might have been a useful thing, but then how do you explain what all the different stats do? Yeah, we're just grinding, getting Titanite, so I can upgrade my my ninja sword to +5 and make it magical. Like, you can figure out what is going on, right? Like, people say you can pay attention to what's happening in the HUD, right? You can use the explain buttons, but a paper manual is really useful. Especially in a game with no pause screen. Especially considering how, like, mechanically intensive this game is. Something that explains to you how the game works when the game is as nuanced as Dark Souls is really useful to have around. I'm not saying it's a bad game, I'm saying it didn't have to be as obtuse as it is. Let's go say hi to Zygmire. That's too bad, not the Batman. Yeah, but, I mean, we can get the Magic Uchi Katana now, instead of getting Butterfly Horn midway through An Orlando. Anyway, we've got like 6 humanity, so getting another 7 Titanite is not really a big problem. You can get an enchanted falchion in the Duke's archives in like 4 hours. Point being, we can basically get a if we really were hell-bent on it, we could get an enchanted Uchi Katana very soon, right? Because we could go and kill the Hydra in Darkroot Garden or Darkroot Basin, and then climb up and get the Enchanted Ember from the Mushroom People. Who do I recommend this game to? My friends. I recommend this game to basically anyone who has an interest in games. Like, I wouldn't recommend this to, like, my parents, right, who play solitaire sometimes. But, you know, if there's somebody who invests time into games, I think this is a very good game. Yeah, I love that one picture somebody drew of one of the mushroom parents with, like, a lightning Zweihander sticking out of its chest with the caption, "You have fucked up." The only mod that's really fairly important for playing Dark Souls on PC is DSFix, because this was just basically, like, shoveled onto PC. Oh really, the Flying Dutchman? I totally recommend this to people who play WoW. People invest hundreds of hours into learning how WoW works, right? And playing that game and grinding. It's a similar mindset. I think they're totally compatible. Yeah, people get warned off this game because they're like, oh, it's so hard, right? Everyone talks about how hard it is. And it's... yeah, it's not super easy. It's not easy mode. But it's not something I'm like... People make this game sound like it is... I've used the analogy before where a lot of Dark Souls community talks about this game like it is a 20-year-old whiskey that they found in their dad's liquor cabinet and drank over a weekend when their parents were out of town. And we're like, oh dude, I found this like scotch in my dad's liquor cabinet and I got fucked up. It was awesome. And it like, you know, every sip was just like, oh, and it was so like strong. And then I woke up with a nasty hangover, but I got wasted. And it's like, You're gonna miss. Which isn't to say that you need to be a connoisseur to enjoy this game, it's just like... you're treating it as a punishment when it's actually something that can be savored and enjoyed, right? Like, you're treating an enjoyable element of the game as a punishment and trying to make it sound like that makes you tough, right? Yeah. I mean, I also shouldn't be telling anyone how to play games, right? Do what works for you. It's just that... people also insist that that is, like, the hardcore mode is the only way to play the game, right? And... like, Yahtzee actually did a really good review of Dark Souls, right? Where he had a very similar experience with a game that I did, where I was playing games, like, in a semi-public or in a public setting, right? As a streamer, and people were like, oh, well, you have to play Dark Souls if you like hard games. It's so hard, it will make you so angry. But it's just, like, the hardest game ever. You would really like it if you like dying over and over and over again. And this is the thing people actually told me. Right? And I'm like, that sounds awful. That doesn't sound like any of the ways I want to play a game. We need 4 more? Fuck it. No, we bought too much. No, everything is ruined. Everything's ruined. And Yahtzee came back to it, and he actually wound up playing the game once, and he was like, oh, I get it now. It's actually got a wonderfully deep setting that's, kind of doled out to you in bits and pieces, and it builds atmosphere very well, and, like, you really feel, like this is a world that is on its last breaths, and the set design is amazing, and it's all thoughtful, and none of that has anything to do with just getting murdered over and over and over again. Wow, I remember Little Nemo Dream Master. I mean, not much of it. What made me want to play it after the hype was Alex gave in and played it. And he told me, oh, it's actually just really good. Honestly, give it a shot. And I was like, oh okay, cool. I'll try it then. But honestly, what drove me away from the game was its community telling me that it was like, oh god, can I even... Do I have the souls to go and have Rickard make this magical? I've seen a couple of lore videos, they're pretty neat. Oh, no, I don't think other games feel watered down in difficulty at all. Yeah, like, Dark Souls does, like, this bait and switch on you, right? Where you're like, oh, it's an action game, right? And, it actually, in most situations, it gives you a lot of time in combat to plan things out. And it really rewards planning. Once you get into combat, things happen very quickly. And you kind of need good twitch skills. But there are also breaks in combat where you can kind of like step back and do more planning and preparation. So the fact that like the combat in this game actually rewards patience more than twitch skills. Because you need to be able to read an enemy's moveset, right? In order to kind of like effectively fight them. And just like immediately using abilities is punished, right? Like if you try to parry something when their parry animation or when their attack animation isn't at the correct point, you will miss and take like massive damage. Right? Twitch skill, like just Twitch gaming. Not Twitch the streaming service, but like reflexes, right? I really need to play Undertale. A friend of mine bought Undertale for me. He's like, you have to play this game, but you have to play it not on stream. Do not stream this game. I'm like, okay. And I have never played it, but I need to. Because it was a gift, and it was from somebody I trust quite a lot. Yeah, sorry about that, Ninja Eye. Okay, so I'm gonna go and make this magical. Hold on, Slack is going off. Okay. Everything is fine. Good night, Snurky. Okay, so I'm gonna go get a magical Uchi Katana and then, like, do gargoyles? Yeah, that's good advice. I should get the Smith box and a repair box. What I should do is just play under... maybe what I could do is play it on stream, but, just not look at chat, turn chat off. What's up, fool?
You can call a fool a fool.
A fool?
You streaming?
Yep. Come in, sit down. You're gonna bargle harkle wargle?
Mighty sweet katana you got there. Where'd you get it?
I bought it at the mall.
Oh.
Guy wasn't using it.
Is it 420 stainless?
Yep. Splitting damage, you know. Like a pro.
Oh, magic?
Yep.
Uchi gata. Oh, Rickard.
I love how his strategy for not going hollow is do not give a single shit.
Yep. Just like Ellie Brosh.
Yeah. Oh, wait, really?
Kind of. Well, have you ever read her strip about depression? There's two of them.
No, I haven't.
Well, I think the first one kind of culminates in her suddenly having this sort of epiphany or maybe a meltdown
mm-hmm.
where she just stops being able to feel stuff and feels invincible.
Yeah.
Huh. And then it picks back up when she's like, I've always wanted to not give a fuck, but I didn't realize there was a difference between not giving a fuck and not being able to give a fuck.
Ooh.
Which is where she ended up.
Ooh.
That strip is so fucking good.
Hmm.
By the way.
Yeah, I should read that.
It's very excellent. My favorite part is the piece of corn.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you remember that, right?
Yeah.
Because I think I actually know why it was that funny.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously I can't explain it. I think it's just one of those things that it's like if you've gone through like horrendous depression at any point, you maybe can just slightly grok why that tiny
piece of corn on the ground. Like it was under the coffee table or something, wasn't
it? It was so tiny and alone and it was just sitting there.
Yeah.
How is that not so funny? Oh fuck. Just like the little thing that causes a short circuit in your brain, the illustration is really, really good because she's like, so you want to be happy, huh? Fine, I'll make you happy to death.
Beautiful.
What's my favorite non-boss enemy in this game? Oh, that's...
I hate this guy.
What's this guy? I'm trying to think. I'll probably remember when I see it.
Totally okay, Capo Waldo. That's what I usually do in Twitch chats.
Well, There's some streamers that really make a big production about, like, welcoming every single person that shows up.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. And I mean, like, that's their style.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel like that would get exhausting.
How do you even notice when somebody new shows up?
You have, like, I guess you one can of have your alerts. Eyes is, like, pointing in the opposite direction. Obviously, the toxic blowgun guy.
Oh, God.
Yeah, no.
No, no!
No!
Did I get this soul? Yes, I did. Can you actually set a notification?
Well, yeah, like, I mean...
When somebody new comes into chat?
Maybe?
Hmm.
I'm sure there's, like, an IRC plugin or something.
Oh, probably, yeah. Yeah, yeah, that makes sense.
His favorite enemy in this game is Entropy. Endless fuck those mosquitoes.
Ugh.
I can tell you my least favorite enemy. It's those, like, egg sack back guys.
Oh.
I don't even go near that shit. I'm so glad you don't have to fight them.
My least favorite enemy? Torch Hollows.
Yeah.
They're
bullshit.
Lord Gwyn never would have gone hollow.
Wow. That's some rough beats.
If Black... The fuckity?
What the figgity? What the...
What the freaky freak you guys
cock.
Have?
Bullshit cock.
Bullshit, bullshit, bullshit. I don't have any fucking armor.
I hit him like 50 fucking times. Fuck!
If you have no idea what we're talking about, God, where did I find that? It was like back in 97? I think it was on Penny Arcade.
That sounds about right.
Or it might have been like Scary Sugar Shack, where there was a guy whose roommates recorded him playing Team Fortress 1.
Oh!
And...
That sounds just like Matt Brown hates Shields. Although
yeah.
I won't repeat that one because there's just like so much like homophobia in it.
Like,
it's really funny though because the guy is just going apeshit.
Yeah, but they like made a techno remix of their friend getting his ass kicked at Team Fortress
yeah.
1 and just screaming the entire time.
Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, Matt Brown hates Shields is pretty good because they put it to like some sort of like folk music.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just it's a guy getting demolished in Counter-Strike and he insists that the reason he can't win is because somebody on the opposing team is using a riot shield.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And he keeps, like, demanding that he drop his shield. He's like... And the guy tries to cut, and he's like, you had it perfectly, and he cuts him off saying, go suck a penis! Go suck a penis! It's...
Wow.
I had somebody so, like, almost that salty in a game the other day.
Yeah?
I was playing Genji.
Uh-huh.
And I was literally doing my job of flanking and taking out support characters.
Yeah.
And he's like, who the fuck, you know, gets behind and takes out the support? So annoying. And I was just like, I don't understand this criticism. This is literally the role of this class.
Yeah.
I am doing my exact job.
Yeah. Like.
And he was just so angry about it. And I was like, what?
Yeah.
Should I be running straight at the enemy and like, what? What? I don't understand it.
Sorry, what I was saying earlier was that if Black Knights carried a Torch Hollow torch...
This game would be impossible.
Yeah, they would just fuck you up. Gwyn yeah. never would have gone hollow.
Yeah. Actually, can you imagine how sweet it would be parrying those torches? Can you parry those torches?
Probably not.
I've never tried.
They probably just phase right through your armor.
Well, they just sort of like gesture them at you and then all your health goes away.
Yeah, exactly.
Hello,
hi, Paul.
Paul.
What's Hello. Up?
Who else are we waiting on?
Nobody. It's just us.
Is this Ed?
Mm-hmm. Is Heather coming in today?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
She asked if she should, and we didn't tell her to, so.
Okay.
Womp womp. Well,
so
we've done this, we should probably do a TTC and then...
Yeah, so I'm just gonna make it to the bonfire and then we'll call it here.
Yep. Time. That Lord of the Flies action ain't gonna do itself. We gotta get moving.
Yeah, all right. So thank you very much for joining me here today on this impromptu stream of ours.
Well, who knows? Maybe there'll be more. If there's only three of us, we'll see. And, we'll see how much we can get done.
Yeah.
This was asking about AFK tonight. Is going to be Terra Mystica with Heather and Beige and Corey and Ian.
Ooh. All right.
All right.
And I'll be on tech for that, I think.
Yes.
All right. So I will see the rest of you in several hours tonight. So, toodles, and thank you for joining me. Also, I'm going to run an ad. Appreciate it if you watched it. Yeah, click the thing.